Superman is the epitome of heroism, a beacon of hope, justice, and unparalleled strength in the DC universe. But when it comes to living Thor's legendary hammer Mjolnir, the question of worthiness isn't as straightforward as you might think. While many would assume that the Man of Steel, with his unwavering commitment to protecting humanity, would easily pass this test, there is more at play than just raw power or good intentions. Odin's enchantment on Mjolnir demands a very specific kind of worthiness, one that may challenge Superman's strict moral code, his reluctance to kill, and even his deepest fears. Could Superman's greatest virtues also be the very traits that might render him unworthy in the eyes of Asgard? In this video, that's basically what we're going to be discussing. Yo, what's good, everybody, and welcome back to Let's Talk Comics, where we discuss comics and beyond. Obviously, we're just going to be discussing why I specifically think that Superman would not be worthy of lifting Thor's hammer. And before we actively get started into this, the first point that I would absolutely need to make would be talking about the time that he actually lifted it in the comics during a Justice League and Avengers crossover event. While yes, in this specific issue of comics, Superman was able to lift the hammer, it did come under very specific caveats. In this, Superman is wielding Captain America's shield along with Thor's hammer, and his exact wordings are, "Oh my lord, the power, it's never felt so, I never would have guessed. I've got to maintain the momentum." And the only specific reason that I'm actively talking about what exactly he said in this is due to the fact that he says, "I've got to maintain the momentum." It's basically showing and showcasing that he's not truly actively wielding the hammer. He's not controlling the hammer. He's just trying to basically keep up with the power. He's trying to use the power, and the power is just like surging through him. He's not truly being able to control it. It's not something like, oh, how Thor is able to just completely maintain it, and he's not having to keep up with all of the power. He's not having to keep up with the momentum that it is causing and leaving in towards him. This is just showing that he's not truly being able to wield it. He's just kind of using it as of right now. And the main thing that I'm also going to be talking about is right after that. When, after the battle's over, we have an entire scene of Superman trying to pick up the hammer, and it is not allowing it to work. This entire scene is basically just talking about Superman saying he held it before, but Thor quite literally just coming back to him and saying, talking about, oh yeah, there is an enchantment on this hammer laid by my father. Like, it is not going to be easily lifted by anybody else. And talking about the only reason that Superman was able to even hold and lift the hammer and even maneuver around with the hammer was because Odin was probably watching, and he allowed Superman to overcome that worthiness limit for those specific desperate times that they were facing in this specific battle. This just shows that, yes, while he was able to lift it specifically due to some kind of intervention and very special circumstances, he wouldn't be considered worthy under very normal circumstances. That is what I honestly entail for that entire scene. He is only deemed temporarily worthy during this dire battle. And this is obviously seen like as an exception, in specifically, like, this scene is like basically not the norm. This is not like the norm of, well, yeah, he's going to be able to like lift the hammer because he's already been able to do it once. And the fact that he was able to do it once showcases that, oh, because he lifted it, he must be somewhat worthy, because not any person would be able to lift the hammer in any case. But the fact that he lifted it shows that, yeah, he has some worthiness aspects, and no one's ever going to say that he doesn't, but he wouldn't be completely considered worthy. And the main reason I say that would be due to Odin's specific enchantment. Odin's enchantment, "For whoever should be worthy will gain the powers of Thor," isn't just, oh, you have to be worthy in one specific aspect, because worthiness has very many different meanings. Whether it is the talking about the values that are Asgardians hold, including honor, humility, and most specifically, a warrior spirit and a warrior's heart. Mjolnir is a thing created by the dwarves for Thor and like his entire battle experience. This wasn't a complete thing where, oh yeah, you just have to be worthy in this very specific aspect, and if you are worthy in this way, you'll be worthy in every single way. There's good reasons why characters like Spider-Man can't lift it, who most could easily consider worthy in a very good few aspects due to his character. there are so many specific reasons why Superman wouldn't be able to lift it, and Odin's enchantment and specific wording and his meaning behind everything that he said would be the main reason that just kind of disqualifies Superman from ever being able to lift it in any normal occasions. Superman's virtues and his values and moral code just not fully aligns with what Odin's actual enchantment deems worthy. The way that he walks, the way that he talks, and basically his entire way of existing wouldn't just be up to par. His entire personality just kind of goes against what you would normally consider to be something along the reins of what Asgardians would be considered to be worthy. And the main thing that quite possibly is taking him away from that would be his reluctance to kill. While obviously I'm not just going to be specifically stating that, oh yeah, you definitely have to kill to be able to be considered worthy for being somebody like Thor and gaining the powers of Mjolnir, I'm going to completely say that that is a very good, quite big possibility as a specific requirement for being something like that. So his strict moral code against taking lives and his, like, just be, that being a very big cornerstone of his character would be one of the things that quite literally just disqualifies him from being able to hold and lift Mjolnir. Mjolnir often requires the wielder to have some kind of warrior's resolve to actively be taken into account when you're actively being able to wield it. And the main reason I honestly truly believe this is because a king must be willing to take a life in order to rule. Every decision a king makes affects the lives of others, and being some kind of person that isn't willing to take that burden upon himself, he would quite possibly be actively just fighting against that entire rule. Like, Asgardians are a warrior's race. So you not being able to do the one thing that most likely would probably justify doing something like killing somebody that actively deserves it, somebody that you're trying to protect every other people, would just be a very big kind of issue in terms of Mjolnir in my own mind, in my own head. Yes, you can easily disagree with me in terms of, oh yeah, like, I'm absolutely wrong, and we could easily debate that in the comments, but that's not what I'm here to do. Like, that's, I'm just telling you what my opinions are. Superman's entire reluctance to kill would be a very big issue. While normal Superman, like, has that very big reluctance, characters, like, specifically, like, we're talking about, like, Henry Cavill Superman probably might be a little more worthy because he actually has some killing intent, and he's not the normal Superman that we have, the big blue boy scout. He's more of a kind of person that's on the more gray and darker side, so he might have a better chance. But in most normal cases, Superman just wouldn't have that actual full-on thing just due to that reluctance to kill that would be allowing him to do almost anything of actual importance in terms of lifting Mjolnir. Superman is a deeply compassionate and constantly aware of his person type of character, and all of the immense responsibility that comes with this extreme and exorbitant amount of powers, he would often grasp and fears and have to deal with his fears of misusing his abilities. These inner conflicts and self-doubts honestly could probably prevent him from being deemed worthy, as Mjolnir usually demands some kind of actual confidence and certainty in one's own abilities and actions, and having to be constantly in fear of using your own active superhuman abilities that he has to such an extreme extent could be one of the other reasons that he just wouldn't be completely considered worthy. The main other thing that he would just kind of qualify him as not being worthy is the cultural differences in heroism. The Asgardian definition of heroism is a more aggressive, battle-hardened approach, which very much contrasts with somebody like Superman's preference for a peaceful resolutions and diplomacy. Superman's brand of heroism being noble and not extremely willing to do a lot of different things would just really contradict what Mjolnir would specifically want and require. Yes, wielding Mjolnir requires you to be noble, but to a very specific extent. And Superman's exact kind of noblism would probably be even too far much for something like Mjolnir. People like Thor, people like Beta Ray Bill, everybody that has held the active hammer as of yet has never been somebody like Superman, whose brand of heroism is so specific and so strict that I just don't see a way of him getting past and getting through those specific differences in what being worthy truly means and the differences of heroism and being worthy actively entails between these two specific characters. So, in all fairness, Superman being able to wield something like Mjolnir, I just don't truly see as being feasibly possible. His entire character and his entire story that he's been able to build out of so long of a time just completely contradicts of being able to wield something like Mjolnir. And as I said, y'all can debate with me in this on the down in the comment section below, when most of you are probably going to say that I'm absolutely wrong, and I will absolutely take that if you have any actual true proof. But it is actively in my full opinion that Superman would just not be anywhere near the standards or true full-on things of being worthy for something like Mjolnir, when we have people like Thor's entire legacy and Odin's specific judgments on what being worthy entails. So if you guys did enjoy this video, please leave a like, subscribe to the channel, hit that notification bell so you guys can get caught up with all the latest videos. I hope you guys did enjoy this video, and I'm gonna guess that there's gonna be a very large debate in the comment section below, so I really look forward to reading that. But with all that said and done, peace.